So now we will see how to add currencies to our project in Primavera. So for that you need to go for admin and then currencies. So once you click currencies, you can able to see the available currency like currency ID, currency name, currency symbol and the exchange rate as well. So these things we can able to create by ourselves. For example, now I'm just going to put add. So the new currency came. So you can put the currency ID like RS per rupees, Indian rupee, and then here you can specify RS dot, and the conversion rate that we can update later also. Now I'm just going for general. Here it is like currency ID, currency name, currency symbol, and then exchange rate. So currency symbol, now it's updated. You need to click outside so it will be updated. And you can go for appearance, you can go for decimal symbol, so pointer, comma, digit grouping, you can go for comma, and then you can go for 0 to 2 decimal places. Now I'm just putting close. Now you can go for edit and then user preference. So here we have currency option, so time, units, dates, currency. So in currency we can able to click this icon. There you can able to see the created one. For example, now we have created RS. I'm just clicking and then you select. Now you can able to see the currency symbol is RS dot and then the grouping 0.00, two decimal places. Now you can go for close. Now we can able to go for project. Now we can go for a budget plan or spending plan. Now can able to see here everything is RS dot rupees. So again, I'm just going to create another one. Like for that, I'm just going to consider rupee symbol. So this is like rupee symbol. You can just copy it. And then I'm just going for admin currencies. I'm just going to add. So I already added. I'm just going to tell you again. INR1. It should be unique, you know. So that's why INR1 I'm putting. And then India rupee, and then here you need to control V. Now we got the symbol and you can just go for, you can put dot if you want, or you can go for underscore if you want, and I'm just going for close it. Here it is like a positive means it will be like this. If it is negative means it will be in braces. If you don't want braces, you can select any of the format. Like in Excel also, you know, if it is like minus, it will be in braces. If you don't want that kind of format, you can change here. So that you can do from here, and then I'm just going to close it. Now, if you want to make changes this to the created one, go to edit, user preference, currency, and you need to select from here. So double click also enough, and then now you can able to see the currency symbol and the digit grouping, and you can go for close. Now can you able to see, now it changed. Now here in project, in edit, user preference, even you can just go for show currency symbol, you can hide it and you can close it. Now you can able to see only the currency without symbol. Now you can tick it and you can see without digit, decimal digits, and I'm just closing. Now it is like a without any decimal digits. So I can go for digit grouping with decimal digits and just closing. Now we got it. If you want to again change, you can go for user preference. You can select INR, this one that I have created before, and I'm just closing. Now can you able to see it is like updating immediately. So like this, you can able to create your own currencies in Primavera and you can able to use that in your projects.